cuentos, el abuelito. How's it going, guys? On this occasion, I'll be doing something a little bit different. And even though it's the first English video, I'll be uploading a lot more. So don't forget to leave a like and a comment for any recommendations or suggestions you guys might have. I'm thinking about uploading all of the classic scary stories in Spanish into English, such as like La Llorona, El Jinete Sin Cabeza, El Charro Negro, and many, many more. So if that's something that you would like, let me know in the comment and we can go from there. With all that said and done, let's get to it. I'm bringing in three scary stories that happened on 4th of July. Story number one. My family asked me if I wanted to go with them to check out the fireworks on 4th of July. I was 16 years old at the time. I really didn't want to go, not that I had anything at all against fireworks, but I really wanted to go out drinking with my friend Matt. We figured that we would break into an abandoned school building in the area. Lots of teenagers would do that, and it was well known. It was a well-known place for drinking and smoking weed, where the police would leave you alone. I met up with Matt and he had scored some weed too. I didn't smoke at all too often, but every once in a while I would. He was a bit worried that being the fourth, a lot of people would have broken into the school. Whenever we had gone before, we had never come across any other teenagers. Like normal, we snuck through the opening in the fence that surrounded the place. At that point, everything still seemed fine. There wasn't really anything to indicate that anyone else would be there. We went behind the building and there was a broken door we used to get in. Still, there was no indication that we weren't alone. We found a room and we began smoking the weed and drinking a little bit. It was really nice. We weren't too far from the firework display that we couldn't hear the fireworks going off in the sky though. We were probably in there for over an hour when Matt gave me a really weird look. "Did you hear that?" he asked me. I told him, "Yeah, I can hear the fireworks." He shook his head and told me that wasn't what he meant. "I think I heard something in here." I thought maybe he was just enjoying the weed a little too much. He insisted though that he heard something in the other room. When I suggested it was probably just more teenagers drinking, he decided we should go look for them and see if they wanted to hang out. I really didn't care too much to do that, but I went ahead and went with him. We were walking down the hallway and I still hadn't heard anything, but Matt even told me again that he heard some noises. I began to think that maybe Matt was messing with me or trying to scare me or something like that. I had to brace myself waiting for him to try and scare me. I then heard something too. It was a firecracker. It had to be. I may have even had heard it before but mistook it for something from the display. There had to be someone in one of the other rooms letting out fireworks. No big deal really. Fireworks were legal for just anyone to have. The displays were done by the city. We came here for illegal drinking and illegal smoking, so it made sense someone might come there for illegal fireworks. So we found the room. There was an open doorway and there was a little bit of light coming from it. We decided to go through the doorway and introduce ourselves. Matt told me he'd offer them some weed so they didn't think we would narc on them or anything. We looked in the doorway and froze. There was two people in the room, but they were dressed as clowns. One was sitting on the floor with a bunch of firecrackers in his hand. The other was standing up and facing the door. He had a huge sparkler in his hand. You know how when someone has a sparkler, they write words in the air. He wrote "Hi" with the sparkler to us. The other one quickly lit a firework and threw it at us. We just turned around and ran out. It was too odd. We remember previously when the whole clown thing was going on a year earlier. We had seen many YouTube videos of clowns doing weird shit and dangerous stuff. We were terrified at the weirdness of what we saw and what might have happened. We looked back once and the clowns had not come out of the room to follow us. But we didn't stick around there though. We left the building in a big hurry. I don't know. I don't think we were in danger. Like I mentioned, the clowns didn't even try to follow us. But it was just a weird thing to see. Story number two, Home Alone. This is a pretty freaky thing that happened to me a while back on the 4th of July. The people who live in my neighborhood tend to really go all out during this time. For days, they are letting off fireworks, but on the 4th, everyone brings out the big ones, and they do them all night long. I was home alone. My parents had gone to visit relatives for the 4th. I stayed home. Being a teenager, it was always great to stay home alone. You know, when you get the house to yourself for a while. I didn't have any parties or anything like that though. I just took the few days to watch TV and eat a lot of junk food. On the 4th, it was actually a bit louder than usual. The fireworks starting during the day, I couldn't tell what the exact fireworks were being used, but I knew they were very, very loud. When it gets to be nighttime, most of the people in the neighborhood go out to the porch to look, watch, or set off their own fireworks. I really didn't care too much to do that. I just remained in the living room and tried to read a bit. An hour into nightfall, it was super loud. The fireworks were constant. I imagine that this is what it would be like to have been in the Blitz in World War II. I couldn't watch TV and they kept making it very difficult for me to read. As I was sitting there, I suddenly heard a loud noise that definitely wasn't a firework. It actually sounded like glass breaking in my basement. I immediately looked up from my book. The first thought was that someone was setting off some firework close to my home, and they hit and broke that window. We had one of those basements that was not really underground on one side, sitting on the side of a hill. Worried that the house might catch on fire, I got up and ran to get the fire extinguisher. I grabbed it, got up and ran over to the basement door. During this, the fireworks were still going off, of course, so it was a bit nerve-wracking. I ran down the stairs to our family-furnished basement. I didn't see a fire. I flipped on the light and almost fell on my ass when I saw someone standing there. There was a broken window and he was over by my dad's bar, and he was grabbing bottles of liquor and putting them in a bag. He of course noticed me when I turned on the light, and at first he did nothing. He was a really big and scary looking dude. I didn't know exactly what to do. He didn't have that problem though. He came towards me holding a bottle of liquor in his hand. Fortunately though, I wasn't hesitant as he was bigger than me. I remember that I had brought a fire extinguisher down to the basement with me. Acting through what seemed like impulse, I pulled the lever and sprayed the guy with the hose. It stopped him and nearly knocked the large man off his feet. What was important was that it gave me time to run up the stairs and close the basement door and lock it. I called the police immediately, telling them that someone had broken in. They came, but the guy was long gone by that point. He still stole several bottles of alcohol though. The police filed a report. They didn't catch the guy, thankfully though. He never came back either. Story number three. When I was in junior high school, I had problems with a bully named Brett. I never knew exactly why he picked on me though, really. I wasn't nerdy or unpopular or anything like that, but for some reason, this guy really had it against me. And he was much bigger than I was too, so even when he tried to get me to fight him, I avoided it. I'll just give you a couple of examples so you know what kind of guy Brett was. Once I was in class, the teacher wasn't there. As I was sitting there doing my homework, I felt something hard hit me on the back of my head. He had thrown a book at me from several rows back. Once he had a friend of him hold me and squeeze a water balloon on me too. He went around telling everyone that I had a wet dream. Yeah, that one is kind of weird, but a lot of stupid junior students laughed at it. I was happy when summer came around. He didn't live by me, so I knew I wouldn't have to see him for at least 3 months. The first month of vacation went by like a dream. I played baseball on a local league, and we had been winning nearly every one of those games. Our manager wanted to take us out for pizza and then to see fireworks after the game on the 4th of July. We won our 4th of July game. The pizza was great. And then afterward, we went to the park to watch fireworks. It was pretty crowded that day. We put down some blankets and got ready for the show. As I was sitting there, I noticed Brett and one of his buddies. the one that had held onto me during the whole water balloon thing. They were coming on my general direction. We were all still in our baseball uniforms, so I tried to pull my cap down a bit in the front to make it seem like I was someone else. I didn't think Brett would really do anything, nothing when I was there with all of my team members and our manager and coaches. But still, I didn't even want him to know I was playing on a baseball team. He did notice me though. He looked right at me. He then elbowed his friend and he motioned over towards me. They both laughed. I assumed it was because of my baseball uniform. I don't know. He seemed like the type of guy who would find it funny that I played, but they didn't give me any problem at the time. They walked by kind of close to us. He kept trying to make eye contact with me though, but I did everything to avoid him. I was unsettled for a while, but when the fireworks started up, I quickly forgot about it. It was an amazing display. Always found it quite patriotic and fun. Well into the display, I even completely forgot that I had seen Brett to begin with. If you've been to firework displays, you know that they often end with a few minutes of constant fireworks. It's loud and quite amazing. Many of us were standing up during this part, although we had been sitting for the majority of the time. During the finale, I felt something from behind push me. I didn't fall over though because it wasn't that forceful. However, when I turned around, I saw Brett and his friend standing there. Suddenly, my face got hit with a lot of light and pain. I had to close my eyes because of the pain, so I didn't know exactly what had happened at first. I was to find out later though that Brett had lit a Roman candle and sprayed it right into my face. In spite of the sound from the fireworks, I could hear what happened next. Our team manager ran and grabbed Brett and told one of the other coaches to go get park security. Another coach grabbed me and tried to see if I was okay. Fortunately, I had closed my eyes quickly enough that there was no damage to them. I had some little burns on my face, but that was all. Brett spent some time in juvenile hall. I don't think it really did any good. He was the exact asshole he was when he got out. Hey guys, if you guys enjoyed the stories, make sure to leave a like and a comment, and I'll catch you on the next one. Remember, stay safe and vigilant.